In this video, we're going to take a look at some of my favorite new features that Apple introduced with the Reminders app in iOS 17. Specifically, we're going to look at how we can add sections to our lists, how we can have the Reminders app add sections for us automatically for groceries lists, and we're going to look at how we can view our lists in columns. Let's take a look at what's new with the Reminders app, or my favorite new features in the Reminders app with iOS 17. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the first thing that we're going to look at is sections. Let's go ahead and open up the Reminders app. I have a few different lists here. Let's take a look at my hardware list. With the hardware list here, I have a number of items that I want to get from the hardware store. Now, if we look at this, you're going to see that they could be in different sections. I could put hoses, sprinklers, grass seed into a gardening section. Or what I could do is I could put light bulbs and extension cord into an electrical section. In order to do that, all we have to do is just go and start adding sections, and then we can move these different items around in those sections. So how do we add a section? Well, it's pretty simple. All we have to do is just go up to the three dots, the more here, and then what you're going to see here is new section. I tap on this and I type in my section name. So let's just call this one gardening. Now I want to add another section. So now what I need to do is go back up under the more button here and we go over to manage sections. Now that we have sections, I can no longer add a section. What I need to do is I need to manage it. And then when I tap on manage, I'm able to add a new section. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to call this one electrical. And I have one more I want to add. This one we're going to call tools. So now I have my sections here. How do I move my different items into there? Well, basically we just use drag and drop. So now I go back over to hoses here and I just drag and drop over to gardening. We take sprinklers, drag and drop over to gardening. So I'm just moving these around into their respective sections. This goes into tools, extension cords, goes into electrical. We got a couple more here. This is a tool. So we don't want it in a sub there. There we go. And we want light bulbs under electrical. So now I have those arranged in sections. In addition to that, when we add these sections, what we're able to do is easily add different items to a specific section. We don't have to use drag and drop anymore. As an example, let's say I wanted to pick up a fountain under gardening. All I have to do is just go over here and I type in fountain. And now that is under gardening. I want to add a new tool. I just go down to tools here and I add a new tool. If I don't want to have it in a section, I go down to the very bottom here and I add a new reminder there, and it's not going to be in a section. Now we can also manage these sections. We can rearrange how they are in our list and we can rename them. To do that, what we do is we go up to the more button here. You're going to see manage sections. I go over to edit, and then from here I'm able to rearrange them. And if I tap on the name, I can change the name. I can also drag and drop the section here to rearrange them. And then if you want to close them, you can tap on the arrows to the right to close them. So those are our sections. This works really great for this type of a scenario. Now we all have a grocery list, right? Let's take a look at how sections work with grocery lists. With grocery lists, what the Reminders app will do is create these different sections for you automatically. So I'm going to go back over to my lists here. And I have a grocery list here. And I have a few different items in here. I have some fruits, I have some dairy products, I have some meats in here. Now, what I could do is go up under the More button and add some sections in here. But what Apple added with the grocery list is automatic sections. To do that, what we have to do is we have to modify the list. So I'm going to go back here, and if I tap and hold on grocery list, because I need to modify this list, you're going to see that I have list type. And right now it is set for a standard. When you create a new reminder list, it's automatically set to standard. When I go and switch this over to groceries, and then I tap on done, watch what happens. I go over to my grocery list, and you're going to see that I have all of my sections there. So now I'm able to add more breads in here. I have my dairy, egg, and cheese. I have my frozen foods. And being that these are regular sections, what I'm able to do is manage these. I can go and rearrange them. I can go and rename them. So it places them in there, but then you can go and modify it yourself. So I really love that for grocery lists. The last feature that I'm going to talk about is columns. I think this is a really good feature too, especially if you use a reminders app for project management. So I'm going to go back over to my lists here. And then we're going to go over to my new macOS Sonoma features list. So this is like a project. You're going to see that I have these sections in here, record, edit, post, and I have the different videos in there that I want to work on. Now this works great. It looks good as a list, but with something like this, it might look a little bit better as a column view. Well, all we have to do to switch the view is just go up under more here, and then you're going to see view as columns. When I tap on this, you're going to see that they are now set up as columns. And now what I'm able to do is drag and drop these into their respective columns, so I can easily move them around. If you want to rename a column or edit the section, basically a column is a section, you can do that as well. You can just go up to the top here, tap on it, and you can change the name. Or what you can do is go up to more here, and you're going to see manage columns. Basically, it's a section. From here, I'm able to add a new column or edit the column. If I move this back over to a list or view it as a list, this will now say new section and edit section. So basically, the columns are the sections. So if I wanted to view my grocery list as columns, I could do that as well. We can turn any list into a column, and we can turn any list back into a list view. So those are some of my favorite new features with the Reminders app on the iPhone and iOS 17. I really do love the sections, particularly the grocery lists, where we can add sections to it automatically. And in my case, for specific lists, we can do this with any list, but I really don't like to view my lists as columns all the time. But for specific lists, it does come in handy. So those are some of my favorite new features that Apple added to the Reminders app with iOS 17.